Today on Cabal Casts, we are in Counter Conquer 3 King's Wrath again, doing a video commentary. So today we are on Tournament Badlands, which is actually a very good 1v1 map. Quite popular, almost as popular as Twisted Rift. So here we go, we have Granola 17, which is just Granola in this game. Guess he just switched his name in King's Wrath. He's playing as Black Hand versus an old player, RTS Champion, playing as the random. And then Jinkola is Observer. The reason I say that, Jinkola, is because he or she is Canadian. So here we go. This is a Tournament Badlands, sorry. So here we have RTS Champion. He's playing as a GDI faction, so I'm not sure if he's playing as GDI Vanilla, Steel Talons, or Zocom. He's playing as purple. And jump over here, we have Granola 17. He is playing as the orange Black Hand. So he's going for selling off his start of turn, getting a single engineer squad. He's probably getting two because there's two tip spikes on this map here. What faction is RTS Champion? He is Steel Talons, I think. Yes, yeah, Steel Talons, yep. So he's going for two engineers. Oh, wow. He's going light. He's going pretty light on the scouts. He's only going for two rifleman squad scouts. Usually you need quite a lot. Looks like he's confident that the Black Hand squads... Oh, no, he has three of them. Okay, that makes a lot of sense. And meanwhile, Granola has one, two, three... three scouts of Quebec Cabal squads, and he's going to be capturing both of his Tiberium spikes. He has his refinery out, same thing with RTS Champion. And looks like RTS is probably going to be going into Granola's base. We see that if Granola's quick enough, he might be able to catch the Quebec Cabal squad off guard, but nope. I don't think he saw that, so RTS Champion is going to get a good scout off on Granola's base. Oh nope, Granola does see it. He sells off another shredder turn and makes RTS Champion not going to be expanding to his base, so yep, he probably, maybe can only see maybe to here or something like that. You see that the Quebec Cabal squad has taken out another one of RTS Champion's scouts, so that means I don't think RTS can see into Granola's base, and this provide Granola the opportunity to do a rush of some kind, because that's what Black Hand loves to do, is they love to rush, and RTS Champion's not confined about this. He's going to be going for another refinery. He just placed it right there. And Granola also go for another refinery, so Granola is skipping on the rush strategy. So I guess RTS Champion doesn't have nothing to worry about, but still he can't see into Granola's base, so he doesn't know what's about to happen, a flame tank or nothing at all. But I guess he's confident now that if there's no flame tank or Reckoner, then he's probably going to stay. A single Wolverine scout has been built up here just to take care of those infantry squads, and is expanding with his MCV. Another harvester comes out from RTS Champion, and Granola has his fourth harvester already out, and since he can see into RTS Champion's base, he doesn't need to build a scout, so he's just going to be expanding down to the south there with his MCV going through the Tiberian fields. So it's pretty cool how the graphics look when they're on ultra high. They seem pretty awesome. So looks like they're probably going to reach the Tiberian field at about the same time. RTS Champion deploys his MCV, and Granola deploys his MCV about 5 seconds later, but that's no problem. He's been on, he's building another power plant, so, I don't know if he's been building a barracks, so I wonder what he's planning on doing this, maybe going for an early game infantry spam, that'd be a good thought. RTS Champion's going for some pit bulls, and pit bulls will do pretty good if he can get a number of them. He's going to go to this blue Tiberian field here, which surprisingly nobody went for blue Tib just yet. Looks like they're just waiting. Granola's decided to switch around and go down in the south. He already has a harvester on the way to the blue tip field, and Granola's built an engineer with a couple of infantry squads to protect the harvester from any type of harassment, and that's a good thought. Five pit bulls are coming to the map. RTS Champion is coming in for some harvester harassment, but he's going to see a bunch of infantry squads, and looks like they're just going to bypass. One pit bull will go down, and some shredder turn build and cell squad, some shredder turn to conventional ball squads are going to be coming out. I'm just going to push those Pitbull's back, but they're not going to be going back. They're going to see a bunch of bikers, and then these bikes. Oh, RTS Champion should have targeted the bikes because he can destroy them a lot faster than those harvesters. And one bike will not go down. Getting repairs from that war factory is going to be good. RTS Champion lost four of his pitbulls and didn't really do anything damage. That's a single Wolverine squad is doing some work on that heavy harvest, on that harvester, not heavy harvester, that's what Steel Talons has. RTS Champion's going for a command post, and he's going to be going for some orcas. Holy cow, he's got four orcas already. Wow, RTS Champion is really going to go for the heavy attack, and Granola just sees it right now. Looks like he wants to stop that heavy harvester from gathering the blue tib, and this would be a very good pickup for RTS Champion, taking out that harvester with the blue tip. That's denying Granola a $1,400 harvester, and however much blue tip is cost 2,400, I believe. So that's not going to be good for Granola. He's going to be a little bit behind in the economy, but at the same time, since RTS Champion went for that airfield, he's a little bit behind in his economy as well, just bringing this second heavy harvester to the green Tiberian field to his expansion. But he still has these four orcas, and now that means Granola is going to have to build some Mentier to counter those orcas. But he's got some bikes here, and they take down the harvester from RTS Champion, but these bikes have just been absolutely massacred by the orcas, and he lost two orcas, but he left maybe just right about four bikes, so that may not have been worth it. It may have been close, but RTS Champion lost two of his orcas. Now he's got some titans on the field, and those protect against any type of anti-vehicle. Granola's still going for some bike-buggy combo. He's still building bikes from his original war factory and his natural refinery, War Factory still building up bikes. He's got a second refinery out. Same thing with the RTS Champions. Got 3-2 on this field here. A couple of Wolverines for defense, whereas those he's expanding again with his MCV on tier 2. Didn't want to expand to tier 3 just yet. He's getting AP ammo. AP ammo is almost complete. A couple of Titans are coming onto the field here, and RTS Champions going for his third expansion. And this would be a huge pickup for RTS Champion if he can get down his economy down on that field, which would deny Granola any type of way to expand on there. But looks like he's going for some huge power plants, and he's not even at tier 2 yet. He just played down as tier 1.5 for Secret Shrine. Looks like he wants to go for some Black Disciple upgrade and mix in those infantry forces. But now with RTS Champion going for some Hammerheads, and he already has a bunch of Wolverines as well, it's gonna be pretty bad. Oh no, those bikes are attacking RTS Champion's harvesters, and these harvesters are gonna be going down. One harvester already go down, and another one will go down. RTS Champion is just losing. He's losing harvesters left and right. He needs to do something about that. Another harvester may not go down. Oh, come on, Granola. It's worth it to destroy that harvester. And he does. He loses a couple of bikes. But that's not worth it. A veteran orca. But that doesn't last long, as the Varricorn just got shattered by those bike attacks. So that was a pretty good attack there by Granola. Three harvesters for, like, what, six bikes? That was pretty good. And even a bike buggy down in the bottom here. Or just a buggy. Destroys a hammerhead. That levels up. Manal's about to be destroyed. Another hammerhead is coming in. Granola, meanwhile, has a lot of... he has a good chunk of infantry squads here. Mostly rocket squads, though. He needs at least five or six conventional ball squads to really beef up his infantry. Looks like he's doing pretty good, though. But RTS Champion has recovered his economy slightly. He's got those three heavy harvesters with those two refineries, but now he sees the conventional ball squads out there. And Granola is expanding with a second MCV. He's taken up to tier 2. He's got his operation center. Now he's going to go for, like, maybe Spectres or some form of anti-air. But this beefy army right here from RTS Champion, it's mostly just tight, mostly just Wolverines, but he needs a lot more anti-infantry, because this is a lot of conventional ball squads and Milton squads, well, mostly Milton squads from Granola. So he's just going to be continuing with the... with the rocket production. He wants to have a lot of those rockets, and now he's starting to build some watchtowers. And this is not a good maneuver, RTS Champion. You should not go in like that, because there's a lot of anti-infantry. Plus there's a Mantis right here, so Mantises will do some wonders against Hammerheads, and this would be a huge battle coming in right now. It's lots of rocket squads, and RTS Champion really doesn't have the Wolverines or anti-infantry to do this. He's using the Titans to crush, and Granola is not using the XSplit. Now he's using the XSplit. And surprisingly, RTS Champion is destroying this anti-infantry squads. That's a huge surprise. I could have sworn that Granola would overwhelm that force no problems, but now RTS Champion is destroying that construction yard, and I don't think Granola really has the forces to deal with that. And that construction yard is definitely going to go down, no question about that. Hammerhead right there, Sam site destroyed, and that second construction yard from Granola, it looks like, is definitely going to go down. He just placed down an Obelisk of Blight, but it's low powered, and that MCV will go down. He just placed down a refinery. That's a waste of money, because that's just going to get destroyed. And he had to place a power plant there. So it looks like maybe, since he placed that refinery down, he has build radius, but he has a lot of Wolverines on his disposal, and a purifier out from Granola, so this will help him out. And a tier, and clicks. Here comes the Tivane detonation. That'll be huge damage. All those Wolverines just got massacred. And the double punch with a Catalyst missile, and... where'd he fire it? Oh, he fired up here. Oh yeah, there's a bike in there. There's a single bike in there. Took out a refinery, so that was a good shot in there. But I think a better reason would probably shoot it right here, because I think refineries are close enough to maybe for a click, but I guess Granola never saw that. Now Spectres are coming out from Granola 17, and his Tiberium field is almost depleted. He's got like seven harvesters on that field, which is not good. He needs to go for some blue tib to keep those harvesters busy, and a small contingent of rocket squads, and Wolverines. Narcy's champion still is on tier 2. He's just building his tech center right now, so he's going to be a little bit behind in the tech race, because Granola now has his obelisk of light and a couple Spectres with a purifier. And these shredder turrets now are causing some damage against those missile squads. Granola needs to have that charged particle beam upgrade. That purifier goes down to those Wolverines. And these infantry squads are absolutely just getting absolutely massacred. That Spectre can't pack fast enough to and destroys the Spectre. These Wolverines now, finally, those shredder turret based defenses have the charged particle beam upgrade. And now those Wolverines. Oh no, low power! Low power by Granola! And those Wolverines are just going to make a gateway going towards the second expansion from Granola, and hopefully they can destroy more power plants, and that's exactly what they're doing. They're destroying more power plants. Granola needs to place down another Shredder turret and base defense. He needs to power up his power plants, because none of them, I don't think any of them have those tip core upgrades. Oh, one of them does. A second MCV out from Granola, and more power plants are being destroyed. Those Shredder turrets now are finally, one of them powers back up, and that veteran Wolverine goes down. Those Wolverines are just doing some scouting. If they can, if they're lucky, they can take out the Tiberium chemical plant. I'm not sure why Granola still has it. He could have sold it for some more cash, and now he sells it for $1,100. But now this buys RTS champion some time. He's got his tech center up, placed in a very dangerous position. I would have placed it a little bit further back here, because then he can not get attacked by like Spectres or anything like that, or Redeemer. Now he's got some behemoths, and behemoths are wrecking Granola's base. He still has build radius with that refinery. If RTS champion can focus there on the refinery, then that means he can destroy any build radius that Granola has. Now this has caused RTS champion to lack anti-infantry now, because Granola is slowly getting back his infantry cloud, and these rockets now, the third MCV is back to the party, and more Spectres are coming in, and they're going to be targeting down the Wolverine. Not the Wolverine, the Heavy Harvester. That's a pretty good pickup. Pretty good there. The Zephyr Cloud is moving into the base now, and since the Spectres are providing some splash damage fire, they're helping out take out those watchtowers. The behemoths now are moving back here towards the war factory so they can get some repairs, and now they're definitely take down one of the Spectres. Oh, that's last behemoth shot missed, and that construction area is in a very dangerous position. But that provides the build radius that Granola needs to help fund his operation. But he's all out of Tiberium, and he needs more Tiberium now. But RTS champion is lacking Tiberium, 3-1 on that field right there. And he's not harvesting on this field either because of Granola being here. Three Spectres right now, and they're targeting the watchtowers. Actually, this will be a good pickup. If Granola can see it back here, he'll have a huge pickup, because the behemoths are like juicy for a strike. And there's a scan there by RTS champion, seeing what he can see. And there's Spectres right now carting underneath the construction yard. But now this is what I was talking about. See, good splash damage from those Spectres. Just got a nice shot off those behemoths. And those behemoths were forced to stop their firing. And now we have some bikes now with Tipcore. Tipcore bikes, always, always good. And now those bikes are just going to be moving around the map, trying to take out those behemoths. A couple of hammerheads, taking out the infantry. FHG cloud, and those bikes rockets missed. Behemoths now returning back to their base. Same thing with Granola. His construction yard, surprisingly, is not being under attack. He's building more Milton rocket squads now. He's got a couple more Spectres. Hammerheads are coming in, two more hammerheads, and those bikes now are trying to destroy those hammerheads now. Behemoths now attack, destroys a harvester. Both of the guys are still holding onto their tube tip spikes, so that's giving a little bit of money. Now the construction yard is under attack again by RTS champion. And now Barracks trying to force to sell off his construction yard, and that's not good. These hammerheads now are trying to take control of all the Spectres, but that's a bad maneuver. All those hammerheads are being destroyed. 1,500 for 5. 15 times 5, that's 2,500. That's $20,000. That's $25,000 for 5 hammerheads, because hammerheads are... is it 14 or 15 for a hammerhead? It's 1,500 for a hammerhead, but he's still building hammerheads. And that'll help out RTS champion a lot. And Orca Strike, it missed, but it still made the Witchy Squad's roll. And now the Infantry Cloud is coming in, trying to destroy the Behemoths now, and they're destroying the refinery, forcing, if the refinery goes down, then that means that Granola loses his build radius in that vicinity now. those Wolverines do some wonders against the infantry squad, destroys the refinery, and that means that RTS champion has full control again of this field. And this also means that Granola lost all his build radius and is forced to retreat back. He needs to get some harvesters back on this on his main field so that he can get more economy going. But it looks like he wants to leech from this blue tavern field right here. And meanwhile, he's resorting back to a hip fast and run tactics. This small contingent of bikes is destroying a lot of harvesters and destroying that refiner out there. Surprisingly, RTS champion powered down his command post. I guess he doesn't want to have anything to do with that just right at this minute. And those bikes now are just moving. Those bikes now are just destroying the hammerhead slowly. If the bikes didn't have tip core, then maybe they would. The hammerheads didn't have had a lot better time. And one more last shot by the tip core bike and destroys that hammerhead. So that's pretty good. And Granola forced to sell off his remaining structures at the huge green Tiberian field. But now he needs to hopefully do something. And he's going for Redeemer and Journey Facility. And the Redeemer is about to come out soon. And RTS Champion can use this time to build up on maybe some Behemoths and some more Hammerheads. He could probably even go for Firehawks. Oh, a Flame Tank! A Flame Tank! We see a Flame Tank by Granola. And this will be a good pickup here. And destroying, he takes down an airfield. He's on force move, and oh, because of he stopped those behemoths, take out that flame tank. But that was a good move. Destroyed the airfield. That's pretty good. And there's a command post right there, still power down. So that means that RTS champion is only tier 3 and tier 1, but not tier 2. And the Redeemer is now out now by Granola. He's slowly harvesting any Tiberium he can find. And a couple of hammerheads here from RTS champion, taking out what he can. Power plant speeder comes the tip court stem turns, and a full volley almost takes out an entire squadron of hammerheads. That hammerhead is on zero life right now, and destroys the last of the power plants that's near him. So that Granola needs to force to build more power plants. More bikes are coming out right now from Granola, so that's all he can build right now. And RTS champion is getting his economy back in order. He's got 4-2 on this field, bringing in his fifth harvester to the safety because he doesn't have any harvester up here, and he needs to worry about bikes. A lot of green Tiberian field here is good for RTS champion. If he ever loses out on this field right here, he can immediately retreat back to his main to get more Tiberium. We see Space Command on plank here from RTS champion, and that's gonna be pretty good to shockwave artillery the Redeemer. And surprisingly, Granola did not put a flame weapon inside the Redeemer. It's two engineers, so looks like he's not worried about infantry squads, and that's understandable. But at the same time, if it has a flame on it, then he can do wonders against the refinery. Wonders against all the buildings, but looks like he decided to go for two saboteurs instead. Okay, nice infantry swarm here from Granola, and the Redeemer is slowly moving into position. But he's got to be careful that he doesn't get caught out by the shockwave, and it looks like the Redeemer's retreating back to his infantry cloud, and those infantry forces are going to be destroying that single Wolverine tank. Small condition of Wolverines has made it around the side of the map, and they're taking out the Spectres, and that's going to be one Spectre is going to be a very good pickup. The infantry force right here is going to be absolutely massacred, and we do see another one click. We see Tip Catalyst missile and Tip Vein detonation. And that honestly didn't do a whole lot of damage. Yes, he took out a refinery, but at the same time, it just damaged the heavy harvesters. So not a whole lot of economy was lost by RTS Champion. And he managed to diminish Granola's forces again. Oh, and we see that another... What's this? Oh, it's bikes moving into the base now, and we see that the artillery has been shot. Redeemer has been locked down, but I don't think it's going to be enough. Tip Vapor Bomb destroys a tech lab and another refinery, and Space Command Plane has been attacked by the bikes, and those bikes are moving, making around outside the map and destroying all of the behemoths now. Did the Redeemer survive? It did survive. And those bikes now destroyed one of the behemoths, and RTS Champion now is in a lot of trouble. He doesn't have any refineries to speak of at all. He just has a war factory, a power plant, and another and a command post over there with a couple of power plants. Retreating back with his behemoths. One behemoth there is veteran. And Granola now is just building more bikes. He's building more bikes, and this will probably work out good for him because he's against just behemoths. And now when Granola can get that rage up, he can just immediately rage his forces, and another harvester will go down. Oh, one harvester was stacked up. He can get one more sonic shot. One more shot of the tick bike would have had another heavy harvester. But now Granola needs to save up his bikes, needs to save up his economy. Pepper can sell that for some more money. And that Redeemer is just standing idle right now. I guess RTS Champion, he needs to get his Yeah, he needs to get his harvesters repaired up as fast as possibly could, because these bikes are just going to be causing major problems there for RTS for Granola. But now these bikes now are just going to be causing the behemoths now to just fire, and there's the rage generator for the first time. And now those behemoths are going to be raged now. That Titan's doing work on those bikes now. And I guess that Wonder Ride, that Redeemer's not going to be crushing the behemoths. Now it's starting to crush now. And EMP buggies now are coming in, and Redeemer is very close to being very close to crushing any of the behemoths. It crushes one behemoth now. These bikes are going to be good for the Grenadier squads and the Grenadiers. And good thing for Granola that he can't really EMP. He doesn't get EMP buggies. He gets EMP buggies, and too bad for RTS Champion that he doesn't have any EMP grenades because he doesn't have an armory. And now the Redeemer now is doing work on this behemoth now, and it looks like RTS Champion is in a lot of trouble now. All of his harvesters have been destroyed. He has no refineries. He has no harvesters left, and all his behemoths has been destroyed. Looks like this might be the end for RTS Champion. Yep. Here comes the fire sale. GG. RTS Champion's been defeated. So that was a good game. Granola was on the back foot there for a little bit, but you just managed to kept RTS Champion's numbers to a minimum, and therefore having to push back into his base and destroy it. So Granola obviously had the most units because he was black hand. Structures, it was mostly all Granola because he had a lot of structures, and Granola had a lot of money. I guess he went to the blue tip field more times than RTS Champion, and therefore had a lot more money. Stats had a 0.63 kill death ratio to Granola, because if he had a black hand militant squad, RTS Champion has 2.62, Wolverine and militant squad 9,532 to Granola, and 8,307 to RTS Champion. So not a very good, or not a very high economy game. Only $2,200 more for Granola. Okay, so there you go. There's your game on Tournament Badlands. And my name's Cabal, and I'll see you guys next time.